Hello everybody and welcome to Acadgild.
My name is Pavan Lalwani and the instructor for Microsoft Excel. In this section, we'll be learning basically on the mathematical functions. Mathematical functions are basically categorized into different parts. We have something related to sum functions, count, average, random functions, round, and the subtotal. So in this section, we'll cover all these particular different topics in different videos. But more specifically, in this video, we learn about how to work on the sum functions. So basically, I have designed four different functions into sum. One is the sum, sumif, sumifs, and the sum product. So let us see those one by one. What I've done is, if you see in the screen, there's a fun file that is mathematical functions, and all the functions are divided into different sheets. So basically, whenever I show you any video, that topic will be working in that particular sheet itself. So right now, I'll go for the first sheet named as sum function. Okay, and you can see there's some random data which is already written on the screen here. It says date, sales rep, sales 2018, and this column I can just hide it. I can just right click, click on hide. So now, what are the functions I'll be showing you in this video? I'll be showing you how to work on sum, sumif, sumifs, and the sum product. Okay, so let us see those. Now, as I said, the data is all about some company where people have made some sales on that particular date. So you can see the date, sales rep, and sales done in 2018. If I want to add the sum of, or if I want to get the sum of sales 2018, we already have a function equal to sum, bracket open, and I can just select this numbers here and I can close the bracket. So this is the simple and easiest method which you can work on. I can press enter key from my keyboard. Now, sum function, you're already aware, it's a very basic. Now, if I want the sum function in some other sheet, let's say in a new sheet. So what I'll do is, I'll first create a new sheet, okay, and I'll just maximize, zoom it, equal to sum, bracket open. If I want sum of those numbers, okay, which is present in the sum function sheet, I have to go back to this particular sheet and then select this data here. Press enter key from my keyboard and now I'm getting the answer as 4310. Okay, let me verify. If you see, $4,300 and $4,310. So if you observe here, the process was very lengthy to get the sum. I'll give you a shortcut method to get the sum of those numbers. So what you have to do is, the step one is, you select this numbers or the range wherever the, you know, the values are present, except the column heading. Go to the name box. This is the name box. You know, all the names are present into that name box. Click on that name box and you can just give the name as sales 2018. You can give any name. Okay, sales 2018. You can give your name, my name, anything. I'll press enter from my keyboard. Make sure the enter key is very important. Now, henceforward, anywhere if you want to use this particular range, you can use the name sales 2018. So what I'll do is, I'll type here equal to sum, bracket open, and I can type as sales 2018 and close the bracket. So if you see, when I say sales 2018, the range has been selected from C3 to C11. And when I press enter, you can observe I'm getting the same answer here. The benefit of using this name range, the topic is name range. The benefit of using this name range is, you can go to any sheet, any place within the same file, and you can just type equal to sum, bracket open, and sales 2018. Okay, and you can press enter, you'll be getting the answer. So the amount of time is saved. What is the amount of time required? You have to type as sum, go and select that range. Here it was like only 10 numbers, so it was very easy for us. Imagine if you have 5,000 numbers, so it is very difficult to keep on selecting and keep on searching that particular sheet. So this name range can be useful into your day-to-day task. Let us come back to the next one. We have the second option, second function named as sumif. Now, sumif is used basically when you have one criteria, one and only one single criteria. Now, let us say if I want sum of only those numbers which are less than $500. So here in this section, if you see, there are only few numbers which are less than $500. So at that time, how you can work with? Okay, we have a function named as sumif. There are only two parameters required. One is the range, that is C3 to C11. And second one is the numbers, okay, the criteria. Criteria is nothing but less than 500. So let us go ahead and try to write this function. I'll type as equal to sum, bracket open. And here, not sum, it is sumif, bracket open, and here I can select this particular range. You see, I'm reading this screen tip which is given here. So first one is given as range, comma, and then in the double quotes you can enter your criteria. I have the criteria less than 500 and close the bracket. So if I press enter from my keyboard, it says the answer is 900. So $900 are the total of numbers which are less than 500. Let us cross verify manually. If I go to this place, I'll keep on selecting numbers which are less than 500. So I have selected 3, 4, and yeah. So if you see, these are the only few cells where sum is, you can say, is the sales is less than $500. And when I select in the status bar, I can see the sum is given as total $900. So it is working absolutely fine. Okay. We have one more option. Now, if I want to calculate some of those numbers, okay, now the criteria is in some other column and I want sum of some other column. For example, the sales or the numbers are in the C column. My criteria is kept into this B column. Okay. So for example, if I want to have the sum of sales done by Pavan, the sales rep name is Pavan. So how do I work on that? We'll be using the same function, that is sumif. I'll type equal to sumif tab, and the first one it says as range. So what I'll do is I'll select this range. Now which range you have to select? So you have to select this first range, that is nothing but criteria range. Put a comma, and then if you see in the screen tip, it will ask you for criteria. So here we have the criteria as Pavan. So make sure you put in double quotes, because whenever you have a criteria in a text, you use double quotes. If you have numbers, you do not use double quotes. Simply you can write the number. Now I'll put a comma, and the third parameter it says as the sum range. So now I'll select this particular sum range. Okay. And I'll press enter from my keyboard. So the answer I've got as $1,000. Let us cross verify. So here if you see Pavan for 300 and Pavan for 700. So total 300, 700 becomes as $1,000. Working absolutely fine. Now we have the third function named as sumif function. When we have more than one criteria, we go for sumif function. Now more than one criteria, you can see in the screen, I have in the cell one, the F1 cell number criteria 1, that is Pavan, and in G column, that is criteria 2 as 20 May 2018. So criteria is kept one in this column, second criteria in this column, and I want sum from this third column. That time we can use the function named as sumif function. I'll go to that cell, type equal to sumifs tab, and now the first parameter it is asking for sum range. Remember, in the previous function, it was asking sum range at the end, not in the beginning. But here, when it comes in multiple criteria, it will first ask you the range itself. So sum range is already this one, the C column, put a comma. You remember, see, I have selected C column, but there, instead of giving C3 to C11, it is giving me as sales 2018. It has given the name range there. Next, we have as criteria range 1. For me, the criteria range 1 is this one, that is sales rep column, comma, criteria 1. You see, I'm reading from here. Now it is saying as criteria 1. So I'll select this F2 cell number, put a comma. Next, it is asking for criteria range 2. I have this criteria range 2 in the A column, put a comma. And now the criteria 2 is kept into G2 column. So I'll select that G2 cell number and close the bracket. So what we have done is basically, sumifs will calculate sum of those numbers with multiple criterias. So first is sum range, criteria 1, criteria range 1, criteria 1, criteria range 2, criteria 2. So this is the method by which you can keep on defining criteria. Now after doing this, I'll press enter key from my keyboard. Now the answer still says as $1,000. Let me verify. If you see 20th of May 2018 with Pavan has 300, 20th of May 2018 with Pavan has 700. So the answer total combined is $1,000 here. Okay. So still I'm getting the same answer here because the criteria is same. What happens if you just copy paste these values? If I press select the cells like this, press Ctrl D. D stands for downfill. And here if you see, now there are total three records. One is 300, 700 and 890. So I'm getting the answer as $1,890, which is absolutely correct because that is matching both the criteria itself. Now let us see the third one. We have another function, that is sum product. Sum product, as the name says, it will calculate sum of those numbers where they are already multiplied. You can see the product, sum product. So sum is of those numbers after they get multiplied. You can see the demo or the dummies example I've taken here. I have purchased few, you know, products from the market. So one is the chair, camera, laptop, bike and car. The price of each product is given here and the number of items I've purchased, the quantity. Now, if I want to calculate the total expense done, okay, from my pocket, what was the total expense done? So I can use, first, I can just normally multiply both this, the price multiplied by quantity. I'll press enter key. And now I'll just drag and fill. So these are the total cost required for each product, not for the entire cost, or you can say entire, the expense done, but product wise, the expense done. If I want to calculate sum, I have a shortcut key. I'll keep my cursor at the last cell. Press Alt equal to enter. Now the total expense done for me is $925. Let's say $925. So what was the effort we have done? First we multiplied, then we calculated sum. Okay, that was a lengthy process we have done. But I'll give you a shortcut method where you can calculate using this sum product. So I'll use equal to sum product, open bracket. And here in the screen tip, if you see, it says as array 1, comma, array 2. So for me, array 1 is this one without the column headings, comma, and second array is the second column here. Okay. So what it will do is it will multiply both the columns and then finally after multiplication, it will give me the answer, that is the addition. Now I'll press enter. Now if you observe, the same answer I'm getting, that is $925, which I got it previously. The previous method was also correct and this method is also correct. The previous method was a bit lengthy and this is the shortcut method you can work with, right? So I hope you have understood how to work on the sum functions. We have seen basically sum, sum if, sum ifs and the sum product. I hope you have understood. That's all for this video.
Acadgild. Average is dead.